Men presume heavenly maidens are fascinating, but my own angel is infinitely more captivating. While earthly beauties offer many temptations, many charms, none can spin the glorious imaginings of my love's creating.
Day and night are not as fine as your downy cheek. Others are like basil, when with you in the garden venerating. Is it a wonder, lovers like me, don't die of the beauty's magnificence, while the miracles of your face are so adoringly penetrating?
The more I drink her beauty, the more beautiful she becomes. Only her hiding under Joseph's coat would I find disheartening. Yea, soul, if Layla and Shirin were as fine as our heart's desire, Fahd and Mejnun would like us be in danger of dissipating. If a beloved gives a false word, she would be left unattended. Could a man ignore her heart's desire if, like mine, she's intoxicating? Yea, soul, I heard the description of peris and huris oftentimes. None of them, in humanity like a human, is radiating. Yea, Navoi, thorns in her street are like flowers in my eyes, and her place in front of me is like paradise, illuminating.
When the glow of 100 candles reflects off your cheek, the sun would hide itself in shame, embarrassed by being so weak. We stand blessed and joyous while in the wind of your existence, when even the healing breath of Jesus would merely be a gleek. From everlasting to everlasting, you cannot be measured. Like a circle with no beginning and no end, you are oblique. You light the taper, brighten the flower, and the moth is inflamed. Frightened by the unearthly light, the desperate nightingale starts to shriek.
Your enchantment was reflected truly in Shirin and Layla. Fahu died, Mejnun became mournful, pitiable, and meek. Your love and beauty, as you wanted, redemonstrated in your names. From this, the essence becomes feeble, lighting of pain, gloss the peak.
Those who wish to reach you need to get through the step of self, since to gain eternity, one ought non-entity to seek. It is not necessary to tell you all my needs and wants. As you are aware, always what from people's hearts will leak. Pour the rain of beneficence in the garden of Navoli, for bloom and nightingale, no leaf, no tune, sans your grace unique.
Spring is inescapable hell for me without you. Red bloom is fire, the white has nicey hue. It's no wonder without you, spring is inferno, since paradise will, without his face, turn to Hades too.
As soon as his dreamy fantasies come into my sight, the tears on my face form wrinkles of affliction rue. The sweetest fruits are tasteless to the sick. It's unsurprising if your sweet lip will vile curses askew. A soul in nothingness longs for heart to hold, because it feels this body for its boorishness, its rue.
Do not say Navoi is unclothed. He wears a robe of non-existence, a misfortune-sown tissue. Having turned a 10-day moon to a smaller arrow, the sky became a herald in front of the king's horse blue.
It is not the wind that smells of musk. It is Layla's unbound hair. Not red tulips on the mount. It is Majnu's blood in this player. On one side is me. On the other, my beloved's in lilac's mirror. We reflected our visage. it is not at all a rose briar. It is my afflicted soul's bird, not the enchanted nightingale. Who? The flower in the garden? To my sweetheart would compare. Thank you.